Hello, my name is Glenn Dyer, and you are watching a Dyer Situation. Today I'm seeing Finding Dory, the sequel to Finding Nemo. And I have to admit, when I first learned they were making a Finding Nemo sequel, I was like, okay. But when I heard that the name is Finding Dory, I actually kind of cracked up laughing. Mostly because just when I hear the name Finding Dory, I immediately presume that the whole thing is just like, Dory just, it's lost on the way home from the parking lot or something, and they spend the whole movie, like, searching around the strip mall for her, and eventually they find her next to a dumpster just hanging out. Like, that's just what I imagine, because she's forgetful, so that's probably what would happen. I don't know. So anyway, first movie, of course I saw that as a kid, Pixar, you know, Pixar's heyday, back when they didn't make sequels very often. It was a good movie. Yeah, I remember watching it several times. It was a fun adventure. It had, had a pretty deep message about how overprotectiveness can be bad towards kids, just, and stuff, and sometimes you need to let them fly free, and yeah, Pixar stuff. So yeah, good movie, but if I'm being honest, like, movie I'd like to see a sequel to, movie I'd like to see more of these characters of, that's, like, pretty low on the list. Like, I'm still, like, excited for The Incredibles 2. That sounds awesome, but Finding Dory? Like, really, I don't see how that's necessary. I'm not exactly, like, and I did like it as a kid, and I do think it's a great movie, but I'm really not exactly clamoring for a sequel. I don't know how it is, presumably in this movie, there's going to be some sort of plotline about Nemo going to college, because that's just what Pixar does. I mean, Monsters University, what else was there? They've had, oh, come on, Monsters University isn't the only one. Oh yeah, Toy Story 3, things like that. I've kind of locked on to a bit of a pattern. I guess 2 doesn't really make a full pattern, but if this one does it, then it will be. Like, 3. That's suggesting a pattern. Is that, these movies are timed so that the kids watching them as children will see them, will now be grown up and watching them in college. So they have college-related material in there. That's just my guess, at least. So if that happens, the pattern is confirmed, and I'll let you know. As general, like, I think the movie will be okay. I'm not sure it'll be as good as the first one, and I really don't think this is very necessary. But you know, we'll see how it is. I don't know. Let's see it. Okay, I'm not going to forget it this time. For every single Disney movie that I've reviewed in the last while, I always seem to forget to mention this short animated film beforehand. I'm not forgetting this one. This one is called Piper. It's a really cute thing about a little bird at the beach learning to hunt oysters and make friends and stuff. It's adorable. There you go. That's the whole thing. It animated wonderfully also. Like the way the birds move and stuff, it looks very very natural. Honestly, it looked very nice. I think I honestly just enjoy the fact that that a lot of these animated films are putting like short and sequences before them, kind of as a warm up. So it's fun, you know. It's like the old days when they had cartoons before movies, and now they have cartoons before cartoons. I don't know. It's just cool. So anyway, to the movie. To the movie. Okay, I didn't hate it, but it's not nearly, not even. This feels like a direct-to-DVD sequel, for the most part. There are some aspects that are a little higher than that, like in this one they went a little more into just the realities of Dory's mental illness and just how frightening that would be to be constantly forgetting things as a mental disorder and stuff, and just in general the whole thing has a lot of symbolism about like disabilities and sickness and how we should learn to encourage them and work along with them and all that stuff. Good message, kind of. But the main thing I couldn't get my mind over, like during the whole film, is that it feels like an ad. And like the funny thing is they go to this Marine Institute and stuff, and it's like our policy is to get the animals, treat them, and release them into the wild again. So this film is following like the last one's message of, animals should be free and stuff. Although in a slightly better way than all drains lead to the ocean because a lot of kids killed their fish accident trying to release them into the ocean after the first movie. So in this one, it's a little better. Although it is kind of suggesting that that fish can survive in any kind of water, which is probably also going to get some fish killed now, but just bear in mind, kids, some fish require salt water, some fish require fresh water. It's not one size fits all. They will die if they're in the wrong one. So, but anyway, it feels like it's selling that park to me. Like, it's constantly referencing Sigourney Weaver, like, Sigourney Weaver endorses this park and stuff, and it's a major plot point that Sigourney Weaver says stuff. It's the whole park and its whole identity, like, launches the themes for the movie, and it feels like an advertisement. Like, when I think of, like, some movies like Toy Story 2, and they have, like, Al's Toy Barn and stuff. The thing is, though the plot is heavily influenced by Al's Toy Barn and the stuff that goes on, it's more about the characters interacting with each other and the adventure and stuff like that, and it doesn't actually feel like like a legit ad for Al's Toy Barn, even though there are ads for Al's Toy Barn in there, just because that was better written, I felt. But this, like, I looked it up just to make sure, and this Marine Institute is entirely fictional, but it feels like it's advertising it to me. And that's what the whole movie feels like. That's what feels like the drive of the movie is advertising a marine park. It almost makes it more baffling that it's not a real marine park, then. But just in general, like, there isn't much of a plot going on in this thing. Like, pretty much, with Finding Nemo, they managed to keep it quite fresh. Like, of course, there's Dory and Nemo's dad. I always forget his name. Marlo? Yeah, whatever. Going across the ocean to find him in Australia, right? And there's also Nemo trying to escape from his bubble and stuff. It's like two constantly cutting adventures and stuff, and it feels natural, their whole adventure. It feels like, yeah, I can understand going from point A to point B here. I can understand, like, the whole, yeah, now they're jumping across jellyfish. That's pretty cool. Or, yeah, they've got this whole secret agent heist plan to get out of the tank. That's cool. Stuff like that. Like, it all seems to work together, but in this film, It feels like the same concept if, like, DreamWorks tried to accomplish it. And DreamWorks does good stuff, but, like... But, like, it's not Pixar, you know? The funny thing is, when I saw the trailers for and the concepts for Inside Out, I thought that looked like a DreamWorks concept to me, not a Pixar one, so I was nervous. But when I saw the movie, I was like, yeah, that's definitely Pixar. Like, no question about it. When I see this, it's like the exact opposite. Like, the advertisements look, made it look like, yeah, that's totally Pixar. I mean, jeez. But when I watch the movie, I'm like, this feels like a different studio. This feels like a totally different creative team behind it. And it doesn't feel like either it had no potential to begin with, or if it did, it didn't live up to it very well. And just overall, not very good. Not, like, terrible. It's not The Good Dinosaur. It's not Cars 2. It's not something like that. But it's, I don't know, probably around the level of Monsters University, like, around that low, where it just, it feels like a hollow sequel. And there's not much to it. There's, they lampshade a lot of the stuff from the first movie, but it doesn't have much of an identity of its own beyond that. Like, as I said, road trip film. Like, not the best. I don't know. Other than that, it's okay. There are a lot worse, but. Yeah, you. I don't know, wait for the next Toy Story sequel or something. That seems to be the only one they really put a lot of effort into. Although, if I'm being honest, I did put some thought into it in the theater, like, just thinking of the different Pixar movies and which ones would be better for a sequel and which ones won't. Problem is, most of them are pretty well-contained storylines and stuff. Like, can you imagine a sequel to Up? Like, what would that be about? Would that be, like, the little kid is now grown up and having his own adventure? Is the old man dead now? Well, that would be depressing. Like, nobody wants to see that. Or what else? A sequel to Inside Out. Well, we have to wait a while for that, but I can imagine, like, the little girl's all grown up now and having different emotions and stuff. I don't know, that feels like rehashing to me. What else? Wally? No, that's pretty much the most contained storyline they've ever done. I can't imagine any holes in there that need elaborating on. Honestly, the only one I could come to the conclusion that would be to where a sequel would probably work in some level is A Bug's Life. But A Bug's Life was so long ago that there's no way they're gonna do it. And it doesn't have that big of a popularity drive to it, so, like, no way. And also, if they're gonna do a Bug's Life sequel, they better release Ants 2 in the same same weekend. That'd be great. But, yeah. Like, pretty much, like, it seems like... Like, honestly, Toy Story and A Bug's Life are the only ones that are really open for sequels. And even Toy Story, they've already milked that to the end. Like, Toy Story 4 is apparently going to be more of an anthology thing. Like, different set of characters and stuff. So, like, jeez. Really, I don't know. Pixar should just stick to making original stuff, or designed a little more open-ended movies if they're planning sequels in the future, I guess. Although then again, I don't know. But yeah, overall, just... would I recommend it? You can do much worse, but... It's not something I would watch in theaters. It's not something I'd be scrambling to see. Maybe wait for like a rental or Redbox or something, because just Yeah. Not worth it. That's all I have to say. And until next time, I'm Glenn Dyer, and you have been watching A Dyer Situation.